Yes, folks, today is something that I would like to address as Brer Caleb, PhD. And as you know by now, my PhD stands for Post-Hole Digger. I continue to work on the proper foundation for the prodigal son and daughter, because we all need some support during this pandemic. Yesterday, a question came in. What makes you a specialist about President Trump? This question came from Taiwan, from a person that is an American. He lives there, he's a white American, and he felt that I was insulting President Trump. Therefore, he would not subscribe to me. Fair enough. Everyone has his own right, his own decisions. But what are we discussing? First and foremost, with regards to President Trump, he is a gentleman that stepped in the limelight with all kinds of comments, exaggerated to the core, and it makes him automatically a public figure. Therefore, he chose voluntarily to be in the limelight, to be discussed, to be checked. But is President Trump the case? No way! He happens to be a gentleman that has a very big mouth, is extremely aggressive, sues the snot out of everyone, and loses billions of dollars in his private life, and I dare say once his presidency is over, trillions of dollars that he scampered away out of the United States of America. Can I prove it? Well, folks, if a dog barks and a cat meows and a mouse is quiet, you can recognize when the mouse is standing in front of a trap. He won't say anything. The dog starts barking, and you know what the cat will say? Get lost, because the cat can't talk. It is the sound we make. It is what we leave behind, the impression, our footprint. Now, some people call it the carbon footprint, but I like to call it the DNA. Everyone has DNA, and we all have something that we are being recognized on. Some people say, well, you have that kind of hair, or why is your hair coming out here? Some other people say, he looks that way, that's why I recognize him. President Trump happens to be the president, that's all. Do I have something against him? No way. He might not be my personal friend, but that is immaterial. What I am debating and discussing is the body of Christ and how the body of Christ is being manipulated again by a man who is callous and couldn't care less except as long as it gets him where he wants to be. Doesn't matter what he does, he's proven it when he had the casinos. How come that I know about this? Because I studied it. I went to the Maryland library, the material that was made available through the university. His case is a special case set for students to understand how you can go from bankrupt to president. See, in the United States, everything is possible. Normally, if you would go bankrupt in Canada, you were not allowed to get a position with money or power or whatever. But in the United States, everything is possible. Bless your heart for that. It is awesome. But what does that mean for us? I ask your support by subscribing. And why is that? Now, first of all, I've mentioned before, I was born June 1950. That makes me 4 years younger than President Trump. I do have a right to talk as an elder. I've learned certain things. I've made my own goof-ups, and some of them were in the billions of dollars too. Yes, folks, I lost $5 billion as well when I got attacked in court and by people that were multi-millionaires didn't know the game, how to play it. I was still looking into a concept that I believed in because I was told this is how it works, to realize that I was not in the right place. And so coming through my experiences and getting through it, understanding and learning, I had to adapt, I had to change. And I cannot say, because I am 70 years of age, I will not learn. So what I did last year, remember when I published my book on Amazon, Deception Protocol for the Prodigal Son, I did something because I was challenged. I was told that I needed to have a video. I had never done social media because I didn't know what it was. Folks, the way I was brought up, social media was email. And you might laugh about it, but social media for me was new. All I knew was PowerPoint. And so PowerPoint I learned. And now that I finally have the videos under control, I think most of it, I come to an understanding. I need some support. Because every 3 months, somebody is cashing in between $3,500 and $7,500 according to emails I'm getting from the analytics. They're stating, if you would have had, quote unquote, so many subscribers, you would have been receiving, or would you would receive today, $3,500, $5,000, $7,500, depending how many clicks I had. Folks, this is new to me. And why was it new for me? I just showed you a picture with a cap on. I don't use ball caps. You know why? Because I'm proud of my hair. Yes, I'm glad I still have hair. And yes, I'm glad that my hair looks curly. But when I was a small kid, I was not allowed to do that. They put a cap on your head and everything that came out of it, underneath of it, was cut off. And not once, four times a month, because my dad was in the Navy. The Dutch Navy. Unfortunately for me, I wasn't in the Navy and I got treated like a cadet. So I swore as a little kid I would never get a haircut. Now, thank God for the pandemic, because now I have a good excuse. I don't need to go to the hairdresser. I don't need to get a haircut because, quote unquote, I don't use that excuse because it doesn't matter. I am in control. But reality is, I'm not in control of what I present. So when I talk about a situation, I'm not talking about President Trump. I am talking about humanity. I'm talking about the fact that we as people are going through something that is not smart to do. And I tell you folks, we gotta wake up. When I talked about DNA, there is a spiritual DNA and there is a normal DNA. And DNA will tell you where you come from, who your parents are, what ethnicity you are, how come that you have blue eyes. I always thought I had brown eyes till I started doing those videos and I see, hey, I have the same eyes as my brother, light gray. I didn't realize that the light fall on your eyesight that changes the picture. And those are things that are described in your DNA. Your DNA will also tell you where your puppy and your mommy are. So if someone has been screwing around, a word that you don't like to use, and all of a sudden the neighbor has a child that looks like you, you know that somebody has been doing something. Because how can you have a twin brother next door while you live here and your mommy and your puppy live with you? That is what DNA will tell you. DNA also will predict certain things, and technology and science is working on it, that they can say you will get this disease, potentially this and that. Now, so we have also a spiritual DNA. The problem that most of us have, including myself, is to understand how can I change, or how can I come to understand that DNA. And that has something to do with a carnal way, carnal meaning fleshly, things that people don't think about because they are, you know, the eyes are wide shut. I don't know how to express it in other way. But when I come to understand that there is a spiritual DNA, it is something that is beautiful, because that is what makes me move. That is what makes me change. That is what makes me a different person. Because as I renew my thinking And we must have heard that from Zig Ziglar and other motivational talkers, that when I change my thinking, tough times never last. But tough people do, because tough people are willing to change their thinking. So what makes me an expert? First of all, I studied for it. I went to the schools, the colleges, and I took my university degrees at blah, 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 not the degrees, courses. You see how easy you can slip. When I exaggerate, I will correct, because exaggeration is not good. Honesty will prevail, because all you have to do is double check. And that is what I did with President Trump. But I noticed something. I am not concerned about Trump because Trump is who he is. He will not change. That is his MO. But I am concerned about the enablers, the people that are leading the organizations from the Christian churches, the body of Christ. How come that they are enabling a person that is lying and cheating and screwing around? Yes, folks. When I say screwing around, I mean literally screwing with the minds of people. I have a picture here, which I will show. It's how you can get the crud out of your ears. Sometimes you can't help it. I use a little mouse. Here is my mouse. And I just clean it out because there's a little wheel here. And you know what the wheel does? All it does is make the movements of my computer simple. It is something I spend hours behind the computer, so I need something that I can work with without getting my hands tired or all in a knot. Some people call it carpal syndrome, but you can avoid that. So I use Logitech, just a promotion. I don't get paid for it. But if you look at it, the little wheel, there is stuff, dust, all kinds of little things. That's the same in our mind. Now, I focus on the ear because what we hear quite often will affect us more. We see with our eyes, we smell with our nose. And why am I pointing out? Because our spiritual DNA picks up the same things. We can get out of the carnal state into a spiritual state that is a higher consciousness. When we die, we bury our body. Our spirit, our soul is alive. And that is that we'll regret later on that we haven't done what we talked about. We haven't changed. And by change, I can improve. Because I was stupid to do something one time, doesn't mean I am stupid. I made a mistake. Whether I'm called Mr. Trump or Brer Caleb, it's immaterial. But when I acknowledge that I can make mistakes, I acknowledge that I'm a normal human being, I acknowledge that I am overweight because I love hamburgers or Diet Coke or whatever you are addicted to. Now you can accept it and you can think about it and now you can change. But if you don't even want to acknowledge, then you're not smarter than a fifth grader, my friend. And the fellow that wrote me out of type one, I appreciate it. Your opinion is important, and I hope that others will also share with me what you think, whether you like what I say or don't like it. Other people wrote me, fantastic, the music that I made, the calming music. I didn't make the music, I just put it together. It's Mr. Helland, fantastic pianist. He promotes his music, but I love the music because calming music, as we are facing the problems, music, nature, will help calm down. Part of change is also turning off the TV and relaxing and indeed becoming yourself. Meditation is part of the process where we can change. But if I don't want to listen to others and I don't want to pay attention to others because I think that I'm more important than anybody else, I tell you up front, you've got a major problem. And I don't care if you are the president of the United States, because for a guy at that position, he should know better. That is the comments from Brer Caleb. Those comments can hurt. They can sting you, but they are honest comments. Comments to help you change your mind. For tough times never last, but tough people, yes, my friend, tough people, they will stand. God bless you. This is Brer Caleb, PhD, and we see you soon. Bye for now.